Hello everyone, welcome to our PI, VAT and GD preparation course brought to you by Learning Made Easy team, a team of IIM grads in association with our e-learning partner gtcube.com. If you are watching this video in YouTube channel, do check out our full length course available for free at gtcube.com/store. This video is going to talk about VAT writing ability test, and we'll introduce this thing to you in this video. So let's get started. So what is VAT writing ability test, right? So you will be given a topic. You are asked to prepare an essay on a paper, right? You generally get 10 to 20 minutes, right? It depends on, B-school. Each B-school has a different time frame for that. And depending on the time limit you have, you would, write your essay in, let's say, 150 to 300 words, right? A general rule of thumb is like writing around 150, maybe up to 200 words in a 10 minute time frame, right? The longer the duration, you are expected to write slightly longer essay with a better structure. So let's get started, about topics. So VAT topics can be also classified into four categories. If you've seen our group discussion video on the topics, we have talked about four standard set of types that generally, would be the source of the topics. The first is current affairs. Right, so the latest happenings in the last few years, as we talked, it could be about demonetization, or it could be about Statue of Unity that got opened very recently. So topics like this, which have been in news in the last couple of years, generally we count them as current affairs. Maybe you can talk about the budget, maybe you can talk about the recent terrorist attack, etc. The classic topics are topics talking about farmers, the problems in the agriculture industry as a whole in our country, the education system, the public education system, in general, the education system as a whole, the rote learning versus understanding, learning with some understanding, conceptual learning versus the health related issues, right? So these are all the question or the topic, as say, could be talking about a specific element of these broader classic elements or topics like the agriculture, the education, the health, the poverty, corruption, terrorism, etc. Then abstract topics are the random topics with no specific agenda, right? So you'll be given a topic where you are asked to write by interpreting on your own, right? So here it's all about being creative and coming up with multiple interpretations, and then going deep to justify and how well you build on it. Finally, case based, a case would be given, and you would be asked to write, so it's like, it could be of multiple types. A simple case would be they will be giving you only 3 to 4 lines, and then they would ask you, if you are in that position, what would be your action? So you have to explain and justify what you would do, right? Versus it could be sometimes a lengthier case where you would have like 4 pages, 5 pages of information with a lot of information, data, tables, where you would be asked to study it and then write your plan of action based on the role that you have been asked to play in that case. Right. So the most important thing that I would talk about in this is that you need to plan some structures so that you can write your VAT in an effective manner for readers. Right. So this is one example structure that we are showing here. Right. You have to actually attempt multiple, VAT topics on your own, and then, take your time to build your own structures. Right. This is just one of the sample. Right, and this would work for most of the things. So this is like a standard one. So the first and foremost, you get a topic. First, you have to introduce the topic, right? So let's say the topic is talking about, farmers and, suicides. Okay, let's assume the topic is talking about how difficult it is for farmers to be, profitable or sustainable in a country like India. So here the topic, you can talk about, you can pick any quote about how farmers are important to a country, right? Or let's say like Mahatma Gandhi's quote that the real development is when we see development in rural parts. And then you can begin saying that 60% of the workforce in our country is working in agriculture. They are fundamentally dependent on agriculture and they are based out of rural. So unless we get this result, we don't see the real development or something like that. I mean, I'm not talking about the whole conclusion per se. I'm saying that you can pick by using some nice quotes or you can talk about, you know, proper definition of the topic, right? Sometimes the topic could be talking about some key jargons like HDI or something, Human Development Index. Maybe you can talk about defining the topic in the introduction. So the most important thing is that you have to introduce the topic properly in the first paragraph of your VAT, so that you're building up, you know, for the remaining arguments. So that whoever reads it, you have to keep in mind that, let's assume that that person might not have a good clue about the topic. The next thing, every topic in general, right, would have two sides of it, right? So let's say if the topic is talking about should government cut subsidies, right? So you can talk about some points in favor of that, you know, cutting down the subsidies, and some point not in the favor of it. So it's like few points where you argue that it's good to cut, few points where you argue that it's bad to cut, right? So whatever the side that you strongly believe in, so more arguments would be going in that area where you are favoring, actually, you know, more like what you're going to conclude at the end, right? So if you are concluding on by taking one side of a you know, argument, make sure that you write more arguments on that. But to make it look like an unbiased and you're also looking at both the sides before you are concluding, it's very, very logical to also talk about a couple of arguments favoring on the other side also, right? So two different paragraphs are maybe two different blocks of the VAT with maybe multiple paragraphs in each block. You need to write about some arguments favoring one side and some arguments favoring on the other side. If let's say the topic does not have both sides of an argument, it's more like this is the right thing to do, but then how do you do it? You know, if the topic is something like that, right? Let's say one of the topic could be that, so there's a lot of traffic that's going on in India or any developing, you know, any developed or developing country. So how can you solve that? And the topic itself says that the public transportation is considered to be the, what do you call it, a key solution for that. So how can we work it out or maybe do something? So here the solution is already being given and it's being asked to talk about how we can implement it, right? So here you should not talk about how public transportation, maybe you can, unless if you have very good points about it. The one way of structuring it is where you stick to the point that yes, public transportation is the way to go forward, but then you should be talking about things like how can I implement it, right? Here you won't have both the sides of argument sort of it. In that case, you should actually use, you know, multiple blocks talking about implementing it. Like you do something like this in public transportation, like let's say we can focus on building metros, right? Maybe you can talk about the cost side of it, right? In the same paragraph, you don't need to go like build it in three blocks. Let's say I'm putting up three arguments about public transportation, and each argument would be one paragraph where I would talk about how that would help to solve the problem, how I can implement it, but also maybe a couple of points talking about the negatives of it, right? There's no solution which would be completely free from negatives. It's just about looking at the positives and negatives. The positives outweigh negatives, so that's why I think it's a better way to do, right? If you are building metro, it's not going to be an easy thing. It's going to be a costly affair, and we have to, you know, bear that. So that's something that you also have to point out. Don't make things look like everything so easy to do if we just go by doing something like this. So it does not come out well, right? A person who is rational and logical, who is thinking things very properly, should be able to even think about the negatives, even on the solution which is being fixed, right? And then you should talk about those. Finally, conclusion. It's really important to have a proper conclusion for the VAT, right? Not necessary that you have to take a stance. It depends on you. It's up to you completely whether you want to put it in a diplomatic way, right? Or maybe put it in such a way that you're slightly tending towards something, but you're still, like, you know, okay with either of them. Or maybe you want to take a very strong stance on one side of the whole topic. That is completely fine, but the whole idea is that even though you're taking a very strong stance on something, make sure that you write down the arguments on both sides, right? Less number of arguments on the opposite side, more on your favor, but you should be showing that you can, you are indeed thinking about the points from both the sides. Looking at both, you know, I feel that one side outweighs the other side. That's why I'm taking that side, right? That's how you should conclude it. You know, the flow should be in such a way that it makes a sense for me to believe that, okay, you are believing this for this particular reason, not just that because you've ignored the other side and you're only thinking one side, then that's like showing that you're completely biased towards something. Right, this is just an example structure, right, which would work for most number of topics. But if you practice more topics, right, you can get a sense, and you can also Google on you know, some structures, and you can build your own structures. The basic reason behind having some standard structures in mind before you go is because you can structure I mean, you can follow the structure as a skeleton and think your points on those lines, right? Let's say I want to write 2 to 3 arguments on one side, so I'm taking this side, so let me think only 2 to 3 points. There's no need to think 10 points, right? It's good to think 10 points and pick the best 3 out of them, but then you also have to understand you have a limited time, right? So it's better to have a proper structure in your mind so that you can even tune your brain to think up to a limit on each block of the VAT so that you can properly build the whole VAT and essay, and then you can write it down in the limited time. Right, so we have talked about this knowledge and application part in GD also, pretty much, not pretty much, exactly the same. It's a group discussion, it's a VAT. In terms of your preparation, there's no difference. I mean, yes, there's a difference in terms of practicing, but in terms of applying, in terms of getting the knowledge, it's the same. Right, you have to prepare on the classic topics, right, on education, health, poverty, terrorism, etc., with more stats. Prepare on the current affairs starting from the last 6 to 12 months. As you have more time, you can go, you know, into more past, like 2 years, 3 years, etc. Make notes on topic as you read on, with a special focus on data and statistics. And also do start reading the newspapers like Live Mint, Hindu, etc., which actually makes good sense according to me. Application part, learn the frameworks. We have done a video on stakeholder approach, how it would be helpful for you to build your own points when you are given a topic. Right, also practice some abstract topics, think, you know, so that you can come up with more interpretations and write. So the best way I would say is this: if you are doing a research on a topic, spend 1 hour, right, to research on the topic. We have done a video on how you will do a research, right, research on a topic, so you can check that out to understand what our take is on researching, you know, on a topic, so that you can build the knowledge on it. Then you've noted down some stats and all, that's fine. Then close everything, take a piece of paper, try to structure a 20 minute or maybe 10 minute, let's say around 200 to 300 word essay on that topic, right, where you are trying to introduce the topic, take some side of it, so you can you know, consider your own topic. Like if you see, we have done a video on researching on Statue of Unity, right? So let's say that the topic would be like, is Statue of Unity worth the money that we have spent, right, or something like that. Is it a right way of spending our national money on you know, structures like Statue of Unity? So here you have one side of argument saying yes, it is indeed a right thing to invest for so and so reasons. The other side of argument is it is not a brilliant idea when you have so many problems in the country, so and so issues, so we can actually invest the money in a better way like this. Finally, you are taking a stance, right? Write it in such a way so that you get practice to the VAT, you get the idea about the structures, you also do the research, and immediately, because you're writing it down, you would remember these things better, and you'll also have the you'll have it like a notes for you to revise it at a later point. Right? This is like the best way to prepare for a group discussion of VAT in terms of building your knowledge as well as practicing for the VAT. So that's it. So we also have a paid course available. So we have our unique My Story form, which has more than 10 pages, you know, which helps you to relive your entire life so that you know yourself better and, you know, answer things which are asked in a personal interview. We also talk about tricky standard personal interview questions, which would be like a pointers for you so that you understand the way to build the answers and you can build your own answers for these questions. And you have to indeed build your own answers. Everyone should have their own custom answers for these sort of questions. Then we also talk about some frameworks which would help you to handle group discussion, the VAT and personal interview, like, you know, how you can structure your thoughts and, you know, put it in an effective manner in a short period of time. We'll show the application of these frameworks with some examples, and that would help you to indeed understand these frameworks better and you can apply them in the real situations. So do check out our course available at gtcube.com/store. Thank you for watching this video. If you are watching this video on the YouTube channel, you can find a full length course available for free along with another paid one at gtcube.com/store. Also do like our partners Facebook page, facebook.com/gtcube3. We are coming up with more courses and updates will be shown in that Facebook page. Thank you for watching this. Let's meet in the next video.